Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about how you can automatically track your links within a PHP list for Matomo Analytics. For the sake of this given tutorial, I'm using phplist.com. So the first thing that you need to do is that you need to go within config and then you go within the settings part over here. And here down below, you get in fact a feature which is by default set for Google Analytics, and you just have to modify it over here in order to edit it and put it to Matomo. Okay. The only thing that this feature is changing compared to the one of Google Analytics is the name of the parameters, which normally shouldn't be a problem if you let them on Google Analytics, but the issue arises. From the user experience side, where they will discover that you are using UTM parameter, which are the one of Google, which of course tend to think that you are using Google Analytics, which of course may not be good for privacy reasons. So that's why it's interesting actually to put it over here, the Matomo settings. Then let's go for a campaign. So here we have different campaigns. Here I'm going to use this one. So I take this one. So here is the message that I'm sending. So here is my message, blah blah blah, dear recipient. Here is the subject of my campaign, and here I have one link. This link not gonna change, right? So if I look at how this link is structured, if I just select it like this, and if I just ask to okay, what's this link about? As you can see, I'm not gonna enter any additional parameters over here. The reason is that the feature I'm gonna show you is in fact overriding those parameters. So if I was adding some parameters here, probably high chances that this tracking may break, or even that the other one may not be applicable too. So I have not yet double checked what would be the conflict here, just that I take as a security of not tracking this link. Of course, there are caveats and advantages of using the technique I'm going to show you. The advantage is that if you have many links, you don't care, right? They will automatically all be tracked with the same pattern. Whereas if you would like to differentiate this link, for example, from an additional one that you may enter over here, you won't get this information within the feature that I'm going to show you. So to say, if you would like to know how many people clicked on this given link, name your attention, which is sending to the same page as this one, technique I'm going to show you is not going to help you. Okay, just going to tell you at the end of the day how many people click on a link which was on your newsletter coming from PHP list. That's what this feature that I'm going to show you is doing. It's not going to tell you for each individual link what it's going to be about. Thus, technically, PHP list could do it with an enhancement. That's highly probable. It's just that right now they don't have this feature, but I'm no expert here in terms of emailing, so I won't be able to tell you if they can add, for example, here the encoder link automatically, or if they can make a difference between a text content or an image. All I can say here is that the technique I'm gonna show you is gonna automatically track the link without much effort, and that's the most important part. Okay, then in fact the magics happen in fact in step number 6 over here. And this is what's happening here. So here it's adding in fact three parameters. To be 100% transparent, it's adding even more because it's adding one that we don't see yet, which is the PK content, and giving it the value HTML. So here I suggest that you don't move this value, basically because here it means who. So who sent the email, from who this email has been sent. And PHP list is definitely a good value to me because it clearly shows you within your analytics that you get some traffic from this given tool that you are using. Medium, there's no mistake as well, that's definitely going to be email. And here PK campaign really depends on what you would like to put here as a campaign. So if you want to put like a newsletter December Christmas, then then feel free to do it. Okay. And now we're gonna send a test a test message. I'm just gonna click on this given message. Normally it should have been received, and we are gonna see how it has been interpreted. Okay, for the sake of this example, I'm gonna go over here, I'm gonna refresh my box. I just received it. You see, I got over here. So just open it up, and here is my link. As you can see, you don't see straight away if it's working, because PHP list is adding an extra layer, at least in my case. Maybe because I'm using phplist.com, but it's adding an extra layer and playing as a redirect, so I don't see straight away what's behind. Anyway, let's click on this one and let's see how it appears. Okay, so here, as you can see, the tracking has been sent properly, with the source equal PHP list, with the medium equal email, with the campaign equal to newsletter December Christmas, and it even added an extra parameter, which is PK content equal HTML. So as you can see, this has been properly added. Now I'm just gonna show you how it looks like within my Matomo. So should maybe be this one. Yeah, okay, great. So I guess I got a visit now, which is coming from Google Chrome, and this is how it appears. All fine, as you can see. Got the name, got the media, which is fine, this is the medium, and got the HTML part, so as the source PHP list. And I can then find this all around in acquisition, and then under campaign, and it will appear like this, newsletter December Christmas. Here I guess I won't get the keyword, so this part will be, oh yeah, this part is empty for the keyword, but then I got the content parameter value, and then I get the medium, and I get the source PHP list. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video.